Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I integrate the 2D smokes using the deep pass inside Nuke. All these white smoke are 2D smokes. I want to show you how I did this kind of holdout and how I placed the smoke in 3D space. And you can see all these things are, you know, really amazing stuff you can do with the deep. So this is the one of the use case of deep. You can, you know, add 2D elements based on the deep value and you can, you know, blend them with the, you know, based on the distance. So this is what exactly I did in this one. Of course, I need to match the color and everything. So by the way, this is the shot from the No Time to Die. I will just quickly show you the reference shot. So we are trying to make this kind of, you know, smoke, and you can see there are a lot of things going on. So very similar, but in this one we have sparks and, you know, very good amount of smoke and everything. So we are refining this one, but this is the, we just show from the beginning. So this is the shot, and this is our shot. So if I just play like this. So this is very quick tutorial to show you the you know, the workflow. So let's begin. Till here we have this precom, and in this one there is no smoke. This is just this thing and the smoke, dust and everything. This is not a final. I'm still working on this one, but I thought let's share with you how I add smokes in this comp. So let's turn off motion blur for now because it will be very heavy. For the smoke, you can see I have these backdrops 1 and 2. Let's see the one. Look, the setup is same. I'm just, you know, changing some few parameters here and there, you know, just all these things. The main idea is that I want to show you. So this smoke is coming from the action VFX. So what I did here, did the chronos, I mean the retime, and you can do whatever the thing you want to do. So this is what I did. I just, you know, did some little bit of tweaking to the smoke. Then I placed this on a card. So now I have this smoke on my card. Okay. So instead of just animating, instead of just moving this card position here and there, what I did, I separate out I use the transform geo to individually transform this parameter. For example, the Z position and the XY, you can see here. So now my card is here. The first question will come in your mind, why I did this. For example, if I take the sphere and if I just replace the sphere, you will see sphere is coming in the same location. What if I change this one? See, because the sphere and the card, everything will sit on the origin, and I'm using the transform geo to, you know, move the position where my camera is. So that is like, you know, procedure workflow. So I don't want to mess around with my original geo. I can, you know, add these transform nodes, transform geo, to mess around the position, and I can line up my card. In this side also, with just a little bit of time offset, and this is how I place it the card. Like this, you can see the two cards are here based on my camera, obviously. So my camera is here and it will move like this up. So for in this case, I want smoke in front of my camera in this frame. Then enter and render this one. Now we have this smoke. You can see at this point, this is very, very straightforward. You can do your 2D comp here and then you can, you know, just render out with the render. Then I have this deep pass. So deep pass is here. And if I just view, we have this deep pass for this entire scene like this. So the idea is you need to do a deep holdout. Once you do the deep holdout, you will see the smoke is automatically get pulled out based on the distance. If I go, let's just disable one of the card. Okay, this one, top one. So let's remove this one. So we have this position. So I can go in my transform geo with a Z and I can just mess around, and you can see it's automatically doing holdout and everything. So that is the biggest advantage of, you know, doing this kind of workflow. So just undo. I have this deep blur node. If I just off this one, it is doing the same thing, but we don't have that, you know, fall off. So if I do this, you can see we are still placing the card in proper space. But if I enable this one, then we can get this kind of a fall off. Okay. So what this node is actually doing is actually increasing the deep value. And that will allow us to, you know, place the card. We are basically just increasing the thickness of the card. So this is just a expression note. So you can see this is just expression note. That's it. That's how we are doing. So that is the whole idea. And then we just converting into 2D image and just multiplying based on the shot. And the same thing I'm doing here and in this side. So I think this is the top one. Yeah, this is the side one. So if I just view from the deep to image, you can see how it looks. So when you merge them together, it will look like this. So this is the idea, guys. So I did the same thing here. So in this side, I use this PXF smoke box, which is really good. So if I view from here, so this is the smoke box we have. In this one also, I did the same thing, just, you know, hold out this one to have a smoke where I want. And in this case, I want smoke mostly on the top area when the camera is looking up. Similarly, the same thing I'm doing here and here. Then I'm doing the pre-comp, and this is what we have. Just let me just quickly show you. So these are the smokes I placed. This is like a Atmos smoke on the environment. So these are the, you know, just like a floating smoke in the environment. That's it. Now let's see how I add those, you know, falling smoke and, you know, some kind of, you know, debris and all those things. For that, you need to go below. So here is the exactly the same thing, but we have some elements. So let's take a look. So these elements we have, let me just show the result. Now let's see, we need to do the time offset. So here is time offset. So this element is come from the footage. So one of my friend just provided me this this element, and here I just remove that part. I remove that part to add the feathering. Here also I did the same thing with this card, and we are putting this element on a card and then transforming with this transform geo, then rendering through scanner, and we have this element, this falling element in front of. So this mimic the falling debris we have in the render. So let me just show you this one, this big piece. So I want, you know, element to behave like that. So if I show you the pre-comps, so these are the all the elements in the scene with the holdout and everything, and then camera will look up like this. So I still need to add a few more. So but this is the, and now we have this element. So I will just show you the elements what I have. So little bit of ray time, little bit of gradient. So see, the I'm removing the color. If the this element have any color, I'm just removing the color with the saturation, and with the grade, see, it's not doing anything because I'm just placing the, you know, card here to see the timing and everything. See that I placed text also to check the time, and this is here. See, this is the one if I view from here. Okay, this will also get hold out like that. So all these are doing same kind of thing, just hold outing each other with this using this deep route technique, and you can see this one also, and we are merging them one by one like that. Then we are just outputting, and this is the thing we have. After doing all of these, then I'm adding a motion blur. This is the result. You can see this is the thing we have. Obviously this take time because all the timing of the smoke, you know, which smoke need to come in which side, you know, all these things are matter. So this is, you can say, this kind of layouting. I'm just matching the position, matching the timing and flow of the smoke, speed and everything. After that, then I will match the color and all those things. In this shot, there is not much going on in the shot. You can see it's very empty shot. So that's why I thought let's add smoke using the deep. So now I want to add that falling smoke, which is covering this part. Obviously I need to remove it because this smoke is penetrating this object, which I don't want. So I will remove this one. But this is just, I want to show you the workflow, you know, the speed and the flow, how it's going. In the reference, if I just show you the reference, you can see in the reference how it is looking. So in the reference, we have this big smoke, which is covering this this big piece, right? So that thing is missing in my shot. There is two ways to get this smoke. First, we need to simulate this one, and second, we need to find the similar kind of element that is falling the you know, this kind of smoke with that rock or something. So we are planning to get the simulation one. So I want that big smoke which is wrapping around this concrete piece. So that is the thing is missing in this shot. Otherwise, we have all the elements. We just need to mess around with the timing, the, you know, look dev and everything. So this is a short guy, just quickly just want to show you the updated thing, what you are doing in this No Time to Die. So the files are available in the Patreon. Make sure to check the link down below in the description, so you can download the project file. All right, I think this is enough for today, and make sure we have a lot of things going on in the background. So I'm little bit not active in the channel because a lot of things going on in the background. Once we are ready, I will continuously provide you with a free asset, paid asset, tutorials and everything. So meanwhile, just stay with me and happy comping, and we will see you in our next one. Have a great day.